In this video, we're continuing on with the coordinate geometry and the centroid worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Remember, in order to find the centroid, we have to locate the medians and then find the intersection. So number 5, the midpoint between R and T is going to occur at 3, 0, since the distance between R and T is 6 units and it's a horizontal line. So 3 units to the right of R and 3 units to the left of T occurs our midpoint. And now we can draw our first median, going from the opposite vertex to the midpoint. Next, we'll find the midpoint between S and R. However, we're going to have to use the midpoint formula, which, remember, midpoint equals x1 plus x2 all over 2, comma y1 plus y2 all over 2, since the midpoint is going to be a coordinate. So S is at negative 1, 4, and R occurs at 0, 0. So let's make x1, y1, this first coordinate, S, and x2, y2, the coordinates for R. So our midpoint is equal to x1, negative 1, plus x2, 0, all over 2, comma y1, which is 4, plus y2, which is 0, over 2. So that's equal to negative 1 half, and then 4 divided by 2 is 2. So at negative 1 half, 2 is the midpoint between R and S. So now we're going to draw that median from our vertex T to the opposite midpoint, which is negative 1 half, 2. Now notice, unlike problems number 1 through 4, in our previous video, the medians do not intersect on the coordinate lines. So they don't intersect somewhere where x and y are both whole numbers. So because it's hard to see where they intersect, we're going to have to find the linear equation for each of the medians. So let's start with S to point. Let's say this is point A, and this will be point B. For the linear equations of both lines, we want to put them in slope-intercept form. Slope-intercept is y equals mx plus b. If we have mx plus b of one line, and we have y equals mx plus b of another line, we can set mx plus b equal to the other mx plus b. And then we can find the coordinate at which they intersect. So this sounds a little confusing, but basically we're just finding the intersection of these two lines given the equation of each of the medians. So for SA, the slope, remember slope is rise over run. So M, our slope for SA, is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. So negative 4 in the y direction, and 1, 2, 3, 4, positive 4 in the x direction, rise over run. So our slope is negative 1. And let me color coordinate this. So we have the M for SA. Now we just need to calculate B, the y-intercept, which we can see occurs at 0, 3. So our y-intercept is a positive 3. So for this line, SA, our equation is y equals negative 1x plus 3. Now let's calculate for BT. Our slope M, we're down 2 in the y-direction, so that's negative 2 over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.5. So negative 2 divided by 6.5 will give us negative 4/13. However, the y-intercept is hard to tell, so we have to calculate for the y-intercept. So let's plug in point T and solve for the y-intercept. So T occurs at 6, 0. So for y equals mx plus b, our y, since this is 6, 0, is going to be 0. Our m, negative 4/13, and our x is at 6, and then we're adding b. So negative 4/13, multiplying that by 6, will give us negative 1/11/13. So 0 equals negative 1/11/13 plus b. We'll add 1/11/13 to both sides to get that b is 1/11/13. So our equation for bt is y equals negative 4/13 x plus our b value of 1/11/13 plus 1/11/13. So now that we have our two equations, for the lines, we can set the mx plus b equal to each other. So negative 1x plus 3 is equal to negative 4 thirteenths x plus 1 and 11 thirteenths. So we're going to say negative 1x plus 3 equals negative 4 thirteenths x plus 1 and 11 thirteenths. So what I'll do is I'll start by adding 1x, or x to both sides. So my x's on my left will cancel out. At the same time, I'm going to subtract 1 and 11 thirteenths from both sides. So 1 and 11 thirteenths will cancel out on the right. Negative 4 thirteenths plus x is going to equal a positive 9 thirteenths x. And 3 minus 1 and 11 thirteenths equals 1 and 2 thirteenths, which we could write as a single fraction, 15 over 13. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to multiply both sides by 13. And doing this, my 13 and my denominators will cancel out on both sides. So I'll have that 15 equals 9x. And then I'll divide both sides by 9 in order to solve for my x coordinate, which 15 divided by 9 as a fraction can be simplified to 5/3. So 5/3 equals my x coordinate of my centroid. So this occurs at 5/3, which 5/3 is 1 and 2/3. And you can see that that is indeed 1 and 2/3. Now we're calculating for our y coordinate. So we're going to take 5/3 and plug it into one of the equations. Let's plug it into our simpler equation, negative 1x plus 3. So y equals negative 1 times 5/3 plus 3, since 5/3 is our x value. So y is going to equal negative 5/3 plus 3. So y equals a positive 4/3, since 3 equals 9/3, negative 5/3 plus 9/3 equals 4/3. So 4/3 is our y coordinate for our centroid. And we would get the same thing if we plugged 5/3 in for this x, since the intersection occurs at the same point, x, y. The coordinate of the centroid and number 5 is 5/3, 4/3. Now I know to get the solution of number 5 took a lot of work. However, I'm going to show you a much simpler formula for calculating the centroid given the coordinates of the vertices in the triangle. And I promise it will be much quicker than what we did in number 5. Now in number 6, we're going to utilize the centroid formula. So C equals x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 all over 3. And that's the centroid formula, where x1, x2, and x3 are the x coordinates of the vertices, and y1, y2, y3 are the y coordinates. So for m, we're at negative 2, 0. For k, we're at 1, 0. And for l, we're at 0, negative 4. So let's make m x1, y1, k, x2, y2, and l, x3, y3. So C equals x1 plus x2 plus x3 all over 3. So that's negative 2 plus 1 plus 0 over 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3, which is 0 plus 0 plus negative 4 all over 3. So C is equal to negative 2 plus 1 plus 0, which is negative 3 over 3, and then 0 plus 0 plus negative 4 is negative 4 over 3. So C equals negative 1, negative 4/3. So our solution in number 6 is negative 1, negative 4/3. So you can see, as I promised, this went a lot quicker than number 5. So let's use the same method in number 7, although either method gives you the correct answer. In number 7, U is at point 1, 1. W is at point negative 2, negative 4, and V is at 5, negative 4. So for the centroid formula, we're adding x1, x2, and x3 together, and then dividing by 3. So that's 1 plus negative 2 plus 5 divided by 3. And then we're adding y1, y2, and y3 together, and then dividing that by 3, which is 1 plus negative 4 plus negative 4 over 3. So c is going to equal 1 plus negative 2 plus 5 gives us 4, and that's divided by 3, comma 1 plus negative 4 plus negative 4 gives us negative 7, and that's divided by 3. So our centroid occurs at 4/3, negative 7/3. R occurs at 0.26, T occurs at 0.02, and S occurs at 7/2. Now remember, the order in which we add doesn't matter, so x1, x2, and x3, the order is irrelevant. So we'll do 0 plus 2 plus 7 all over 3. And again, since we're adding, order is irrelevant. So for y, let's do 6 plus 2 plus 2 all over 3. So 2 plus 7 is 9, so we'll have 9/3 as our x coordinate, 6 plus 2 plus 2, 10, and that's over 3. So simplifying this, 9 divided by 3 is 3, and then 10/3 is already in its simplest form. So 3/10 is the coordinate of the centroid in number 8. And if we wanted to graph that, we'd go over 3, and then 10/3 is 3 1/3. So 3 1/3 occurs at this point, 3 10/3. I'll stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 15, since we did number 16 in the previous video. As always, don't forget to click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up.